I won't lose with this, ayy. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ayy. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay,
on the truck. I had a dream and it stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gon' act?
I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the water.
all the gold, we don't need the silver. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought, yeah.
I bought like 23. Won't fall again and I put that on me. Yeah. I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come follow me, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, yeah, champion, huh? Yeah, we here.
Reaching my goals, I do not feel ashamed. I'm a dog, I'm a beast, and I cannot be tamed. I don't do it for fame, it's the love for the game. I go in like I'm trained. I'm prepared for the rain, they amazed. I ain't break from the sticks and stones they threw. Anything that you could do, I could do it better than you.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The 30 to the 31.
He's brought down
a quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
They'll come up now, second and 4 from the 31. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. He's going to look deep for Moore, and that's caught inside the 30. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What, does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, and that'll bring up second down. Here's Bridgewater. He's got his big tight end, Gronkowski. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 18. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Shotgun handoff down to McCaffrey. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Now that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Throwing is Bridgewater. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's 3rd down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, and they must like the matchups they're getting.
And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard. No. play clock reading 4, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. From the gun, Bridgewater. Taken in by Anderson, but he will not get away. He stops short of the marker, and the Panthers turned away on 4th down. And this crowd into it early. Their guys stand tall on the opening drive of the football game. So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. He gets an 8-yard pickup, and it'll be a 2nd down.
At the 18-yard line.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he's stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on 3rd down.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. Throw left side complete. It's Murray. And he's going to be out. The passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a 1st and 10. On play action, they'll throw. He's got his own pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or 2 shy of the 10. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10.
At the 12-yard line.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
It'll be a gain of 4, and they're going to face a 3rd down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their efficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Scrimmage the 2. They can still get a 1st down if they just get a yard out of this on 4th and very short. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. CD, I know it's just his 2nd year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, 2nd year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward. That 1st down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage.
Bridgewater.
And this is going to double their room to maneuver, able to get it from the 5 to the 10-yard line. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here.
That's the end of the first quarter with no score.
From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah, got the safe completion on third. Now the goal is a punt of 42-7 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points. You're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Following the penalty, it's Kamara. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Tackle made by K'Wan Short.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Second and long. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for the offense.
And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. The pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. This will be out of bounds at the one here, the 12-yard line.
Let's take over first and 10 at their own 12-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, you realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. On the jet sweep, here comes Moore. Tackle there going to Marshawn Lattimore. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and if one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
On second down, McCaffrey. Yeah, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 11 yards there, first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of four.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back there and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal,
shut it down for 2 yards or less, that's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
A gain of 9 yards.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Now Bridgewater. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. We hit halftime, as we do all season. We'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
The tally there, -8 yards. Leads to 4th down as well.
4th down.
McManus will line up for the field goal.
A 32-yard attempt.
And McManus able to put it through. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you get to the red zone, and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there, and you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology of the game at times, isn't there? How much better would they feel running into the locker room, as you noted, with something on the board in a positive fashion? You're exactly right. It's a great opportunity to get that done.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 23 yards the pickup there. So after the run by Kamara, now another 1st and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Throw left side, going to be taken in by Harris. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's 1st and 10.
The 28-yard line.
Now they'll throw here. Out of the gun. Out of the backfield. That's complete to Kamara. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 3 yards the gain there. 2nd down.
2nd and 7. At the Panthers' 25-yard line.
Smith catches left side. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for 3rd down. They'll look to throw again. They open the pass to Smith. Inside the 5 to the 4. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line. 2nd and goal. And this is caught. Touchdown. See if this will stand. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty. No question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty
is? I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Looks good on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. So time enough for a kickoff here. 5 seconds remaining in this first half. Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. Try to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And some room to run now. Pass the 40 before he's out of bounds. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go, ball on the 43. Taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit.
Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
The ball carrier.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a
4-yard. Smith, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Out of his end zone, Bridgewater. Flush to his right. And he finds Gronk. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. the ground, Kamara. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Running with Kamara. Saints now at 6 to their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Blunts to try to add the PAT. Swings right through to make it a 14-3 ball game.
Makes the score Saints 14, Panthers 3.
It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And now he's going to use his head. Bridgewater loses the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw is Bridgewater. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
At the 34-yard line.
Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. He's going to air one out for Anderson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Some boos coming down right now from this home crowd after that call.
Yeah, and that was because of the pass interference call, but for a second there, I thought maybe they'd gotten a look at my appearance as Othello in the high school play.
you were Othello?
Not a good one, let me tell you.
On first and 10, Bridgewater. Flushed out right. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Open man is Robbie Anderson. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He's got his man on the crossing route. And the Panthers are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and 2. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
No gain on the play. leads to second and goal.
So they've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Rob Gronkowski, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. Throwing is Bridgewater. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. He's at the 50, the 30, past the 20, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. He stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee. Maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down. They'll run out of the gun with Canelo. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
Of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Again, it's Kamara. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Got to give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field. And really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down. And he'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, and their defense forces that last punt. And now a chance to tie the game on this possession. Robert Woods, former USC man, the intended target, but it'll be second down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Trying to get it to Anderson, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Janoris Jenkins. And that will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turned to block, find the spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. That's caught. It's Thomas. And the Saints are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll drop the throw.
time to his left. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Caught by Trey Boston. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
He got outside the pocket there trying to improvise. And he was calling for the ball downfield, but still the interception.
I think what happened, he did call for the ball thinking that he was open. I think the quarterback spotted him too late. And that margin that he had on the defenders, that got eaten up, and they came up with the interception.
16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
First down, Panthers.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run, the best ones.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Oh, yeah, that's how we do it.
Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. Twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete to his running back. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans.
Another nice pickup through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Back to throw now on first down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it. 30. The 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
For the extra point.
Coaches preach all the time about opportunities and taking advantage of them, and he did exactly that. I used to have a coach tell us all the time, a lost opportunity is never regained. Well, no regrets here. He picked that one off and took it to the house.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
18-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And the question, can they turn that interception into points? A tie game for the moment in the fourth quarter. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20.
Taken down at the 19.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Second and nine.
They'll buy some time right. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. That is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They throw again on second down. This one's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
That's exactly what they were looking for. If they get another gain like that, they'll be right there in field goal range.
And the tension building. They'll look to throw now on first down. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Four receivers now, three to the right, one to the left. Second down and four.
At the 40,
play action fake. They'll look to throw. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
So
he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
He can run for it, and he will. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A good decision in the end to pull it and run, gets him 9 yards and a first. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. To the right side, and complete to Thomas. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left.
10 at the 21-yard line.
So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And his kick is indeed good. And Berman Street, it'll be alive tonight. The Saints have won it. A little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football.